Welcome to the machine.
Hello everyone, and thank you for joining me for part 2 of this week's look at new developments on the test server. Today we'll have a look at the changes Pixonic has in mind for rocket weaponry. The most impactful of those is the addition of the Orkan-style reload mechanic to the pin, Tulumbas, and Pinata. At level 8, the individual rockets that the Orkan fires have had their damage increased from 979 to 1130, while the Pinata has had its damage reduced from 979 to 900 per rocket, but has 3 additional rockets added to the clip. This works out to an almost 15.5% increase in damage for the Orkan and just over 9% for the Pinata when firing a full clip. I like the changes to the close-range rockets and feel Pixonic is trying to encourage more strategic and dynamic gameplay by burst-firing rockets, as opposed to the usual hit-and-hide death-button techniques that have so far dominated the game. This is not only great news for top-tier death-button Rhinos and Griffins, but increases the viability of less popular rocket platforms such as the Leo and smaller, faster robots like the Stalker and Gepard. The pin has had 224 damage added to each rocket, netting a roughly 12.75% increase, and the Tulumbas is up just over 7%, having 224 damage added per rocket. Even with the damage increase, I still feel like waiting for a fully loaded strike whenever possible will be the best approach to builds like the pin Tulu Griffin or Tulumbas Fujin. It is, however, definitely a game changer for mid-range players, giving you the ability to conserve ammo when a full strike is not needed, or leaving you completely defenseless for as long if your target survives. Builds mixing a Tulumbas with pins and tridents will also benefit from the mechanic, allowing the pilot to use whatever rockets he has available when their trident is ready to fire. I really think the changes to these weapons will shake up the status quo that has been in place for so long, and look forward to the changes being rolled out on the live test server. That's it for my thoughts on the new rocket mechanics, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the footage demonstrating the new weapons. Although I normally speed up the footage and add music for your enjoyment, I think because we're dealing with reload mechanics, it's best if I just leave the footage as is. You can always feel free to change the playback speed in the YouTube settings menu. Please join me for my third video in this review series, where I will take an in-depth look at the Dash lineup of new robots, discussing builds, techniques, and effective counters. I'm Shaolin Rogue, thanks for tuning in, and until next time, good hunting.